الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد من على الأنبياء تقدم وكان أفصح العالمين منطقا إذا تكلم سيدنا ونبينا أبا القاسم محمد اللهم يا ربنا زده شرفا وكرما وتعظيما وإجلالا وقدرا صل وسلم وبارك عليه وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر الله أكبر أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن لا إله إلا الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله أشهد أن محمدا رسول الله حي على الصلاة حي على الصلاة حي على الفلاح حي على الفلاح الله أكبر الله أكبر لا إله إلا الله
الحمد لله الحمد لله نستعينه ونستغفره ونستهديه ونعوذ بالله من شرور أنفسنا وسيئات أعمالنا من يهد الله فلا مضل له ومن يضلل فلا هادي له ونشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له ولا مثيل له في علو شأنه وعظيم سلطانه ونشهد أن سيدنا وسندنا ومولانا محمدا عبده وحبيبه ورسوله أرسله من أرجح العرب ميزانا وأفصحها بيانا فأوضح الطريقة ونصح الخليقة صلى الله تعالى عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه وأزواجه وأولاده وذريته وخلفائه المهديين من بعده ووزرائه العاملين في عهده خصوصا منهم على الأئمة خلفاء رسول الله على التحقيق أمراء المؤمنين حضرات أبي بكر وعمر وعثمان وعلي ذوي القدر الجلي وعلى بقية الصحابة والتابعين رضوان الله تعالى عليهم أجمعين أيها المؤمنون الحاضرون اتقوا الله وأطيعوه إن الله مع الذين اتقوا والذين هم محسنون بسم الله الرحمن الرحيم والنجم إذا هوى ما ضل صاحبكم وما غوى وما ينطق عن الهوى إن هو إلا وحي يوحى O Muslims, believers, These days, many people are busy to observe something that it's really an innovation. What is innovation is really what is happening these days. Some other ulama scholar around the world, they might say, and they say, that observing Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam birthday is innovation. And many other opinion, they say no, they celebrate. And they remember and observe the seerah of Prophet and the Mawlid of Prophet. In any case, we are not going to discuss this, which we can show that it is acceptable in Islam. But we want to go on the big innovation that it is done by Muslim and non-Muslim. Why they come against Prophet sallallahu alaihi wasallam, his birthday, when they don't come against Sayyidina Isa's birthday. Wassalamu alayya yawma wulutu wa yawma amutu wa yawma ub'athu hayya. Peace and salam be on me, peace on me, Allah said in Holy Quran for Sayyidina Isa, the day I was born. Similarly to when Zakaria, when Yahya was, Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala gave to Zakaria his son, he said, Wassalamu alayhi yawma wulida wa yawma yumi. And peace on him the day that he was born. Today we are seeing people are celebrating Sayyidina Isa's birthday, even Muslims. Where on the other hand, they say for Prophet Sayyidina Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam is bid'ah. And I saw that with my eyes in New York. I was invited to a house, Muslim house. He has many scholars. And I saw at the corner of the room, big room, he's a rich person, has a tree, Christmas tree. I said, what's this? He said, ah, Sheikh, no problem, it's okay. I said, no, I don't mind. Allah mentioned in the Holy Quran, وَالسَّلَامُ عَلَيَّ يَوْمَ وُلِدْتُ وَيَوْمَ أَمُوتُ وَيَوْمَ أُبْعَثُ حَيًّا. But why are you putting it? For what reason? He said, for the children. It's no problem. And many people sitting, they didn't say anything. Some people, they didn't like it, but they didn't like that there is a tree. I ask the children, what you are celebrating? They say, Jesus' birthday. I say, who is your prophet? They say, Muhammad sallallahu alaihi wasallam. Do you know when he was born? They don't know. Do you know when Jesus was born? It's the 25th December, although he was born the first of the. So, unfortunately, no education about Islam. That's why people today are observing the New Year. Is there the New Year? Which is our New Year? Is the Christian New Year or the Hijri New Year? Which New Year we have to celebrate? Hijri New Year we have to celebrate. How many of us celebrated Hijri New Year? Today everyone is celebrating the Christian New Year. I'm not blaming anyone or blaming myself, blaming anyone, but we want to say that we have to be careful of what we teach ourselves and our children. How many of you saw Harry Potter? I can say everyone. Some not, but majority. How many of you read the book of Harry Potter? Many. Did Harry Potter his name? Harry Potter took from you money, or you gave him money? What? We gave him money. We gave him importance. We read his book. We made our children to read his books. That lady makes billions of dollars that wrote the book. Every book in this dunya takes from you, not give you. Except one book. That if you keep that book, you will be wealthy and healthy. If you keep that book in your heart, you will be in dunya and akhirah happy. The only book that can give you back, reward you. Nothing other than this book can reward you, except any book connected to that main book. Every other book is human being writings. Holy Quran is Allah's divine knowledge. Kalamullah al-Qadimi, Allah's ancient words. Every letter of this Holy Quran is by itself a universe of rewards that Allah gives you. It is the book that gives everyone happiness. Go to pharmacy. How many medicine they have, drugs they have there? Thousands. And they say to you, this benefits you, this benefits you, this doesn't benefit you, this benefits you. And what they do? They take your money. And it might benefit you, and they tell you on the side, it has a side effect. And this side effect might make you worse. The only one that doesn't make you worse is Holy Quran. وَنُنَزِّلُ مِنَ الْقُرْآنِ مَا هُوَ شِفَاءٌ وَرَحْمَةٌ لِلنَّاسِ. From this Holy Quran, we send on you shifa and mercy. Oh, human being, we are giving you remedies. Every word you read in Holy Quran is a remedy. Every verse in Holy Quran is a remedy for your dunya and for your akhirah. Even if you put it on the shelves, you will be rewarded. But if you read it, you will be more rewarded. You will be cured. And every time you read it, Allah reward you different from second time you reward it. Every time reward will be more than the first time. It doesn't stay the same reward. What is reward? Rewards is levels in paradise, is mi'raj, ascension in akhirah. Everyone will be ascending in akhirah to different levels of paradises. Different ascensions. Every word, every verse, every letter of Holy Quran is divine. Allah is giving it to you and say, this is my book, read it. This is my book, it will heal you. Spiritual healing and physical healing. Oh, mu'min, Muslim, that night in particular, 31st December, evening of 31st December, don't go out of your house like other people, because shayateen are everywhere. Drinking is on the streets. Womanizing is everyone, everywhere. Jumping, dancing, doing everything that Allah doesn't like is everywhere. Qawm Lut is everywhere. Gay people are everywhere. And Allah's curse will come. Don't go out of your home. Stay and read Quran. Or invite your friend and read Quran. Or read Hadith of Prophet Sallallahu Alaihi Wasallam. Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala will see you that you are for His love, for His obedience. You are staying and sitting with your family, with your children, with your friend, remembering Him. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala open our hearts to the love of Holy Quran. As we are coming to pray, also we need to open the Holy Quran and read. Some people, they might say, we don't know how to read. Never mind, but open the Holy Quran. If you can read, alhamdulillah. If you cannot read, try to learn how to read Arabic. Still you are a beginner, you cannot read. Put your finger under every ayah, every word, and move from right to left. And see the meaning in different languages. At least you have shown respect to Holy Quran. May Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala make the Holy Quran nur for us in dunya and akhirah. Light for us in the grave. Light for us in the day of judgment, interceding for us in day of judgment, because it's Allah's divine words, curing us in dunya, taking away our problems. When you delay reading, shaitan is playing. You step over that and read. Shaitan comes in all different ways to stop you from reading Quran. Sometimes I'm reading and tons of telephones comes. Calls, they're calling. In order to stop you from reading Quran. Don't stop. Close your phone. Don't answer. Unless if you have guests, you have to take care of the guests, it's okay. But other, and you are sick, it's okay. You are traveling, it's okay. But other than that, try your best even to read one page. Even to read Bismillah ar-Rahman ar-Rahim and the first verse of that surah. But don't let the Quran left on the shelves. May Allah forgive us. May Allah bless us. أقول قولي هذا وأستغفر الله العظيم لي ولكم ولسائر المستغفرين فيا فوزا للمستغفرين أستغفر الله. الحمد لله حمد الكاملين والصلاة والسلام على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين تعظيما لنبيه وتكريما لفخامة شأن صفيه فقال عز وجل من قائل مخبرا وآمرا إن الله وملائكته يصلون على النبي يا أيها الذين آمنوا صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد الناهي أمته عن دار الجحيم مفخر العرب والعجم مولانا ومولى العالمين المحترمين سيدنا أبي القاسم محمد يا أيها المشتاقون نور جماله والمحتاجون شفاعته صلوا عليه وسلموا تسليما اللهم صل على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما صليت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد وبارك اللهم على سيدنا محمد وعلى آل سيدنا محمد كما باركت على سيدنا إبراهيم وعلى آل سيدنا إبراهيم في العالمين إنك حميد مجيد اللهم اغفر للمؤمنين والمؤمنات والمسلمين والمسلمات الأحياء منهم والأموات واغفر لنا ولإخواننا الذين سبقونا بالإيمان ولا تجعل في قلوبنا غلا للذين آمنوا ربنا إنك رؤوف رحيم يا أرحم الراحمين اللهم انصر المجاهدين في مشارق الأرض ومغاربها اللهم يا ربنا يا الله اجعلهم منتصرين على أعدائهم أعداء الإسلام يا ربي يا الله أعداء الكفر يا ربي يا الله إنك على كل شيء قدير وبالإجابة جدير وصلى الله على سيدنا ونبينا محمد وعلى آله وصحبه أجمعين سبحان ربك رب العزة عما يصفون سلام على المرسلين والحمد لله رب العالمين إن الله يأمر بالعدل والإحسان وإيتاء ذي القربى وينهى عن الفحشاء والمنكر والبغي يعظكم لعلكم تذكرون ولذكر الله أكبر والله يعلم ما تصنعون أقم الصلاة عليكم